Hi, this is Michel Birler. In the previous video, we have seen how to prepare the data for Biogeme. And now we will use this data in order to write our first choice model using Biogeme. The first thing to do is to import Biogeme itself. We do it by typing import biogeme.biogeme as bio. So the first Biogeme is the name of the package, so the whole Biogeme distribution is associated with this name, and the second Biogeme refers to the specific module within the package, which is called Biogeme and which is the core of the software. And here we give it a short name for the sake of simplicity, which is Bio, B-I-O. We will estimate a logit model, and the logit model, like other models, is defined in the module models, so we will import it from Biogeme import models. And then we will need to define unknown parameters that need to be estimated. And this is defined in the module expressions. And the function that we will use to define these parameters is called beta. So from biogeme.expressions, we import beta with a capital B. And now we should import the data that we have prepared in the previous video. The data preparation script is called swissmetro_data. So from swissmetro_data, we will import various things. The database itself. The choice variable, which provides the observed choice. And then several variables. First, the availability variables for Swiss Metro, for car, for train. Then we will have the train variables. We will involve two variables, the travel time and the travel cost. So we have the train TT for travel time, and we had a version which was scaled in the data preparation script. And the same for the cost. We had a scaled version for the train cost. We do the same for the Swiss Metro, the travel time, the travel cost. And then finally for the car, car TT scaled and car cost scaled. Oops, it's not car cost, it's car CO. So as you can see, there is an error here. I cannot import the name car cost scaled because I made a typo here. The name of the variable is not car cost, it's car CO. Good, this is better. Now we need to list the parameters to be estimated. The first parameter will be the alternative specific constant for the car alternative. So we will call this function beta that we have imported above. It takes five arguments. The first argument is the name of the parameter, and I strongly suggest you to use the same name as the name that you give to this variable here. So in this case, we will again type ASCCAR so that we know exactly what we are talking about. This string will be used for reporting. Then we need to provide a default value for the parameter. Well, because I don't know, I will give 0. Then we can give a lower bound. If we don't know any lower bound, we put none. And then we put an upper bound. Same thing. If we don't know what to give, we put none. And then finally, we need to put an indicator to tell Biogeme if the parameter needs to be estimated or not. Here, we would like to estimate the parameter. And therefore, we put this indicator to 0. If we put it to 1, it means that we don't want Biogeme to estimate the value of the parameter, but instead to use the value that we provide here, in this case 0. Okay, we do the same for the alternative specific constant for the train. ASC train. We also provide the default value of 0, no lower bound, no upper bound, and then we estimate the value. As you know, when we have three alternatives, we can only estimate two alternative specific constants. But in order to illustrate this last parameter that I was talking about, I will still define the parameter for the alternative specific constant for the Swiss metro, but I will constrain it to be normalized to zero. So we use the same syntax as above. So here we have ASCSM for Swiss metro. We provide zero as a default value, well, no upper bound, no lower bound. And here we put a one to tell Biogeme, look, do not estimate this parameter. Instead, use the value zero in the model whenever you see it. Then we need to define the coefficients for the attributes. So we have the beta for the travel time. And again, the syntax is exactly the same. So we have beta time, no lower bound. Well, here, for example, I could put an upper bound, which is zero, because I would like beta time to be negative. So just to illustrate the syntax. And again, I want to estimate it, so I put zero here. And for beta cost, I put beta cost, zero, no lower bound. And I put zero for upper bound, and I put zero for the estimation, because I would like to estimate it as well. Great. So this is the definition of the parameters that I want to estimate. And now I need to define the utility functions. So maybe I can write it down here. The utility functions. Here I can comment as well here. Parameters to be estimated. Okay. There are three alternatives. Therefore, there are three utility functions to define. So the first one will be the one associated with train. And I will define it as the constant for train plus beta time times train TT scaled plus beta cost time train cost scaled. So here I'm using an interesting feature of Python, which I used as well for the import of the variables. Whenever something is in parentheses, you can actually split it on several lines, which makes it more readable in your code. So I strongly advise you to do that so that you have a readable specification of the utility function. So this is for the train. We do the same for the Swiss metro. So we have ASC Swiss Metro. Well, I include it, but as you know, I have normalized it to zero above, so it will not play any role. But again, the purpose here is to illustrate the syntax that you can use in Biogeme. Then beta time multiplied by the Swiss Metro travel time scaled plus beta cost times the Swiss Metro cost scaled. Here we go. And finally, VCAR equals the constant for the car plus beta time times car TT scaled plus beta cost times car cost scaled. Excellent. Okay, now we will need to associate each of these utility functions with an alternative ID, because in the data file, these alternatives are coded using an ID. And in this case, the alternative number one happens to be the train, alternative number two happens to be the Swiss metro, and alternative number three happens to be the car. So we will define a dictionary, a Python dictionary, which is defining this association. So we will say that alternative one is associated with VTrain. Alternative two is associated with VSM. And alternative three is associated with VCAR. So this dictionary really defines the set of utility function and associates them with the ID, which is actually used in the data file. We can also define the availability, and we do it in the same way. The availability of alternatives are code it using also a dictionary which associates the ID of the alternatives with the formula to calculate the availability condition. But here, these availability conditions are already defined using these variables here. So we will simply associate each of these variables with the corresponding alternative. So I define this dictionary to be AV for availability. For train, it is train AVSP. For Swiss Metro, it is SMAV. And for car, it is car AVSP. So now we are ready to define the model, and we would like to estimate a logic model. What we need to do for Biogeme to estimate the parameters is to define the log likelihood of the dataset for the given model. What we need to calculate is the log of the logit for each row in the database. And this is what we will define here. We will see that the log probability is defined as the log logit, which is available in the models module that we imported before. And I need to provide three arguments to this function. Well, the dictionary containing the utility function, the dictionary containing the availability conditions, and then the name of the variable that identifies the observed choice in the dataset. Great, so this is basically the definition of the model that will be used to calculate the log likelihood function. Now we are ready to create the Biogeme object and to estimate the parameters. So to create the Biogeme object, we'll say the Biogeme will be equal to bio. Remember, this is the abbreviation we have used for the Biogeme module. And then the Biogeme class is actually written in uppercase, like this. And it takes two arguments. The first one is the database that we have defined in the data script and imported above. And the second one, I misspelled the log prop. So the second one is the log prop that we have defined just above, which is the logarithm of the probability for each of the rows of the dataset. It's very useful to provide a name to this model. So we do it by defining the variable model name. And here I can call it my example. Note that the Biogeme object is created. Well, you can do several things. It's very useful to first calculate the null log likelihood. So the null log likelihood is the log likelihood calculated when all the parameters are zero. And you can do this by just typing the Biogeme dot calculate the null log likelihood. And you need to provide the availability condition to do that. This is -6,964. Great. And now we can estimate the parameters of the model. And it's very simple. You type the biogeme.estimate, and it will estimate the parameters. Now, how to look at the results? Well, the results is an object containing several interesting information. One of them is called short summary. And it will give you some general information about the estimation. So it gives you the number of parameters. In this case, we have four. The sample size, we have 6,768 data. The number of data that were excluded. The null log likelihood that we have calculated above. And then the final log likelihood for the maximum likelihood estimator. And then provide some additional information like the likelihood ratio test, the rho square, the rho bar square, the IKK information criterion, and the Bayesian information criterion. I refer you to the online documentation, in particular the technical report, to get more information about these general statistics. And if you now want to have access to the parameters, well, you just use the function get estimated parameters, and you have here for each of the parameters the estimated value, the robust standard error, the robust t-test, and the robust p-value. Again, if you want a detailed description of what these statistics mean, I refer you to the online documentation. In addition to the object results, that is the output of the estimation procedure, Biogeme also generates a HTML file that you can open in your favorite browser. The name of the HTML file is the same name as the model name, in this case, my_example. And you will find all the estimation information that you need in order to evaluate the quality of your model. So that's it. You have estimated your first model. Now you need to improve the specification, re-estimate the parameters until you reach the best possible model for your dataset. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you and goodbye.